Hello and welcome to the show. We start this week's Failrace episode with BC Carl on GTA 5 and, well, two cars getting a little bit too close on a stunt race. Amazingly, though, despite the mid-air collision, it is a perfect 360 from the pair of them landing and being able to carry on. The amount of times mid-air collisions go terribly wrong is, well, very, very high. So that's an incredible, incredible recovery from the pair of them. Warrior Monkey 12 is racing the quad ski as we're going through these opening corners. Everything gets a little bit too crowded. Some wanted to go for the jumps, others not. They end up across the jumps, gets a bit twisted. However, I'm not quite sure what physics is. It's kind of boomerang mode has been turned on with the quad ski, and that's a long, long way off the course where it should be. Invisible AK on GTA 4 is racing around in a fire truck, you know, as you do. However, the curb has other ideas. The truck, I, as far as I can tell, just brushes the curb, and that is enough for it to decide that said fire truck should be launched onto its roof. Strike on GTA 5 has got, or has found, one of the notoriously derpy AIs. Yes, the Rumpo custom here is having a tough time trying to figure out how to get out of this location. Its best idea is to try and ramp off the wreck of a truck and then manage to beach itself. The big heavy-duty off-roady van is not going to be going anywhere. Nope. That is the good old AI for you. There is nothing that you can do about that one. Slendy Studios on Forza Horizon 3 is racing around off-road, found one of the fun, like, little mini lake things to go and explore with his Audi estate car. Doesn't quite notice the rock, though, as he heads out of the water, and much like the Rumpo custom, said Audi is not going to be going anywhere. It's quite an impressive balancing act that we've got going on here. I'm managing to have the vehicle perfectly, perfectly balanced on those things. A Simpsons fan 03, also on Horizon 3. Now, we saw a fire truck roll off a curb. This time we've got a rally fighter rolling off of a bus. And as it continues to tumble, it launches. I'm not quite sure what it is that it launches off, where it's a bin or something along the side of the road as well, that gives it an extra burst of roll. I don't know, the bus is just driving by, doesn't really care about the big old roll. Timid Ninetales on Horizon 3, racing at the Hot Wheels area. Tried to kind of get past the Corvette, couldn't quite make it stick. Flies off the course. However, the resetting is a little bit questionable for the Viper. That's not quite how a car should be put back on the track. The Viper is just perfectly happy to do its best salmon impression as it is continuing to jump out of the water. And this goes on for quite some time as well. I think the clip's like 2 or 3 minutes long of the Viper being stuck trying to get out. Onto Horizon 2 next with a Kia 72 at Storm Island, carrying an awful lot of speed in, I assume, the trophy truck. Certainly a big off-road vehicle as it's bouncing around. It's a little bit too much speed as it wobbles across. Can't quite get the vehicle back under control as it slides its way through a field. Narrowly avoiding an E-Type 1 tree. There's another tree and a third tree, and then back across in front of another driver tar. How that didn't hit anything, I will never know. Django on Need for Speed Underground 2. Now, we have seen various shenanigans going on with cars in Underground 2 just deciding they want to go to space. It was a hideous car that went to space, I would like to say that much. But, yeah, just vehicles pinging around like crazy. Race Fever on Rocket League is in one of the loading screens with apparently the concrete ball mode. I didn't know this was a thing, but yep, that is definitely not wanting to play ball at all there. Just jump into it, still nothing happening. It is very, very much stuck. And we're going to do Not going to work that one. That Mudkip on Flatout 2 is racing, as you do, finds an opponent stuck on his roof and then proceeds to give him a little bit of a helpful nudge. Very helpful nudge, in fact, as it continues to go all the way down the road until it clips the front of the vehicle. In fact, it clips it so hard it phases out of existence. But, yeah, big accidents for the car stricken upside down. Kyle Jorka on Assetto Corsa. Big crash with his Porsche. However, it's the aftermath of the crash where things get a little bit weird. Now, the car seemed to be missing a wheel. I'm not quite sure what happened to that. I think that perhaps where the wheel should be is now stuck underneath the ground, and it's causing the, well, handling physics of said Porsche to be very, very confused indeed. The camera doesn't really know where it's supposed to be or what it's supposed to be doing here, as bits of the car don't always abide by, well, the terrain, the back off and going through the floor, and it's still continuing to roll at, well, very, very low speeds. Doesn't quite beat my, God, what was it, like 4 or 5 mile an hour roll I think I did on beam, but it's still, yeah, going quite impressively. I don't know why he's doing that. Adam on at Just Cause 3. Well, we've had a Porsche going for many rolls. How about a battleship going for a capsize? Probably not the best of ideas. Didn't quite have the turning circle to avoid the harbour, and that's a very, very upside down boat. And finally, we have Black and Red 81 on NASCAR 2003. I believe it's the player that gets things wrong coming out of the second quarter here, and physics doesn't really know what to do. I'm sure there is a very highly copyrighted song that would be very appropriate at this particular moment in time. I mean, we have seen many weird things happen. NASCAR 2003, look at one of them going over there. That is not a place that you want to be. I can't even tell you what number that is having a bad day. Is it 95 or 55? Well, there's a 5, I think, in all of that. That's not a place that you want to be at all. Yeah, it's a horrendous, horrendous crash. Just in the middle of the field, just gets physics explosioned up into the air. This is following the 31 car that gets fired across to the infield. One of the few cars that gets away with a relatively easy time of it. Relatively easy time, but another viewpoint of the just sudden car explosion as everything gets chucked up into the way. A few of the cars get through okay. A few of the vehicles get through okay and kind of have just normal crashes. Don't know what on earth. See, these guys here, I mean, it's a big shunt, but these guys are okay. They can get back going or get back to the garage in a normal fashion. But, yeah, don't know what caused it, but it is certainly, I think, one of the most spectacular sights that we have seen on this series. The 88, the initial crash of the 88 is okay, as it's now just going to spin across the field on its nose. And then it just starts picking up speed. It just goes faster and faster and faster across the infield. I would love to know what's causing it to accelerate in such a manner. And then again, we have the terrible G-Force death machine going across the track. And I love that this particular car, while the rest kind of all spun their way across the infield and so on, the 88 is actually starting to make its way down the track towards the pit line, actually following the track along here as it's spinning on its nose. God knows how many many RPMs for that poor car. I don't think it's going to be a survivable one there. It does actually end up teleporting its way into... It can't quite make its way all the way to the garage on its nose, unfortunately. It does at some point get counted as broken and teleports its way back to the garage. Would have been interesting to see if the game would have had... It's now started to go more and more across the grass. Would have been interesting to see if it could have made all its way to the pit lane on its nose. That, though, is going to be it for this episode. As ever, if you have clips you'd like to submit to this series, you can via our forums. Be a link in the description. At the very top of the page is the Failrace clip submission section, and in there you can find all of the rules and how to submit them. However, that is going to be it from me. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.